Alright guys, we're back. We just beat the Dragon Rider, who has my vote for the easiest boss in the game. Lysia has disappeared. She goes back to Majula where she sells miracles. She's also got a little side quest later on that I stumbled across, but we'll get to that if we get to it. We need her later on in the game actually, anyway, I think, to give us access to one of the spots. Anyway, we are, I think we're close to, No Man's War. Oh, I thought that was a phantom for a second. Alright, to remember exactly what this area is like. I think up ahead we've just got a lot more of those giants. Yeah. Alright, let's get out. There's no exit? There we go. Yep. There's one. There are the great sword ones. Let's see, I think the... No, fuck that. I think my best bet for killing these ones is just to let them do that overhead swing, and when it comes down, hit them back. You can hit them two or three times before they, wind up again. Two. I think I just walked out on getting hit there. Some items scattered about this area. Another effigy. Old Knight Halberd. Are the old knight weapons any good? I think when I read them, they all have extremely low durability, but very high offense. I don't know. Are they decent? Just don't like things with low durability, especially when I'm between bonfires. Let's get in there. Oh, no. I didn't get a hit on him there. We're gonna play smart here. Alright, now we go. There's another one. I think we're coming up to Lucatiel. There's a bonfire between here and No Man's Wharf. Ooh. Ah, that's what I was talking about earlier. Oh, I guess you didn't hear that, but they sometimes add that fourth swing in. That's where we're going in a second. Let's just check the other end of this hallway. I think there's an item around there. Pointless ahead. No, guess not. Alright. Well. Here we go. Try up and then try down. Is that... Is there an item underneath here? No, that doesn't look like something I want to drop down into. Slower in the water, so it's a little more difficult to deal with these guys, but same concept. Go for it. No! Bad idea. You got messed up. direction. Alright, so that is the area that leads to the wharf. Let's go fully explore this little section. And then I think we'll be done with Hyde's Castle of Flame, or Tower of Flame. I don't remember there being a reason to have to come back here, so I don't think we'll be seeing it again. You dirty, dirty liar. I think there's an item up here. I'd be a little disappointed if there wasn't. Oh, we got a chest. Knight stuff. All this armor and all these weapons are just duplicates. I bet my inventory looks ridiculous. Yeah, I don't know what that is. We need to go back down those steps. Like, I didn't just do this. I think we're hitting a bonfire right up here. I'll talk to Lucatiel, I'll head back to Majula, and spend some souls. Good luck. There she is.
What is it? I don't know you. Things are better that way. You are an odd. Don't hesitate.
Cool. So we have Lucatiel's assistance now. Like I said, that's one of the six achievements I'm missing is acquiring her equipment, which you have to help her in three of the four boss fights that she's available. I believe that's the Flexile Demon, the Pursuer, Flexile Sentry, the Pursuer, this Melter Demon's the only one I used her on the last game. And there's the Lost Sinner. But I'm not sure when you have, like, where you actually go to get the equipment after you've done that, where you meet her and have to talk to her. Anyway, let's level up here. Probably just go more into vigor. We have 4 levels to spend. We'll drop 2 there. We'll drop another in dex. And I think adaptability makes a tiny difference. Resistances, maybe not. Let's get another 20 hit points, why not? Alright, we are going to the wharf. Wondering if we, are missing anything important right now. I guess not. There are two directions I could take right now. I could do what I'm going to do and go to No Man's Wharf, which will lead to the Bastille after the Flexile Sentry. But alternatively, we could go to the Pursuer, kill him, and then enter the Bastille from the other side. Okay. So this guy was the bane of my existence, and now he is dead. We're just gonna get right into this. Probably being a little reckless, but these archers are annoying. We need to make it all the way around. Oh, well, we need to summon the boat first, which is somewhere up there. I'll have to remember exactly how everything's supposed to go. We are gonna explore this place thoroughly again. Maybe the, I don't think I really need to be using the halberd right now. Don't really need it, but we still missed it. I don't think there are any mimics in this area. Am I wrong? I think, I might be wrong, but I'm pretty sure you can see teeth on the mimics before they pop out anyway. I know in Dark Souls 1 there was something about the direction the chain was facing. That's how you could tell if something was a mimic without hitting it. But not this game. I don't think so. Do they even have chains? I think they do. Alright, so we got some guys hanging out. That dude dropped down. Got a party. It's just dual wield here. Ooh. My guy almost hit him. Dark Pine Resin. That's pretty cool. I think you can buy an infinite number of those from one of the merchants later. I forget who. I think Dark Diver, maybe? Hell yeah, I did not kill you. There's one of those guys. Let's go and light the torch. A little power from it, which gives us an opening to just kill his ass. Put the torch out. Not the fireman. This guy. Yeah, I'll be number two. So yeah, this is probably one of the only areas in the game where the torch is exceedingly useful, or noticeably useful. Mainly because of those enemies. Those guys. There's something behind here. Ring of Life Protection? I think that's just a Ring of Sacrifice. Lets you keep your souls and stuff when you die. Oh. Arbiter. Oh my god. The invasions are ridiculous.